Corey here, getting ready to start a small three-room cleaning here. Things have been going really good. Our team Challenger is expanding, it seems like. I sold a Challenger last week or the week before, and sold one yesterday. So they're really selling really well. Now we're also doing financing at Challenger, so if you're looking for a Challenger, I believe the price is about $144 a month or something. I'm not exactly sure. But you're welcome to text me. The number is 512-350-1129. And I can put you in contact with the right people or send you a video that explains to you how the financing works. Anyway, I'm going to show you how to use the Challenger. This is three rooms of, I guess, lightly soiled carpet. So, and I'll try to make it basically a how-to video. You know, you have a couple different choices when you want to clean carpet. You can either do the old-fashioned steam method, or you can do low moisture cleaning, which is a lot less invasive, dries a lot faster, and people are generally a lot happier because you're not dragging hoses all in the house and upsetting everything, and you're not leaving the house all full of humidity because you steamed it. Anyway, let me show you the carpet first. All right, I'm in the master bedroom here. House is kind of small here. Take a look in here first. And Challenger, they make their own cleaning chemicals. They make pads to clean with, and they make the Challenger, the machine, which is sitting over here. It's an orbital. It's not a rotary. It doesn't spin in a circle. It orbits in a random manner like that. So it's very efficient when it cleans carpet. This room here, and then there's this room here. So I think this room is in the best shape. I'm gonna do this guy first. I'm gonna set up the camera and we'll pre-spray right quick, and then we will clean. I'm gonna have to back up the lens a little bit so we can see a little more of the room though. All right, we're recording this in real time. No time lapse right here. All right. All right, now, I'm assuming I can get be seen here. I just want to put a compact disc down. Challenger comes with, it's a package deal. It comes with some cleaning chemicals. It comes with some skitters, which I don't have with me right now. They're in a vehicle, but they're basically like this. They go between the pad you clean with and the floor. It gives it a little slippage so the machine maintains a higher RPM. It's a little happier running than bogging down. So now what it does is it takes this towel, triple thick, this is a triple thick towel made 50% cotton, 50% polyester. So it orbits this through the fibers, and that's what extracts the soil. Generally, you'll have about an hour dry time. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna bring the machine in and I'm gonna clean this room in time lapse. And then these other two rooms look like they'll be a little better. I'll clean one of them in real time. Let me, I'll be right back here in time lapse. All right, we are all done here and I groomed it. I'd left that out of this particular shot here, but we will watch it over here. I think this room here will be the best one to show the entire process on. I'm gonna go ahead and take care of this room right quick. And when I come back, we'll do this room completely in real time. We'll look at this after I'm done. All right, guys, it's the last room here. We're going to show this room in its entirety. This guy is done. The carpet in this room is newer than the carpet in this room over here. And it's a little different in color, you can tell, and the texture is different. So this carpet is newer than that carpet. That carpet did this to my towel. And this towel here, this one, was the one I used to clean this room with. So I'm gonna use a different towel to clean this room with here. So we're gonna pre-spray it first, and then we will watch the Challenger clean. I've got to plug it in. Anyway, I wanna show it here in this video too. I don't show it in enough videos, but there's a difference between rotary and orbital. Rotary means it just spins like your typical floor machine will just spin in a circle. Whereas this guy, it orbits in a random manner in every direction. So there, I just wanted to show that a lot of people, they look at the machine and they think it's just a standard floor machine, and it's anything but that. It's a very unique machine. It weighs 68 pounds. It's easy to transport. You can pick it up and carry it really easy. There's some machines that they make that are orbital that weigh a flat out ton. All right, we're gonna pre-spray this room here, and then we'll move this guy around, clean it. All right, let me point out something here that won't make sense unless I tell you. This guy here, I have a strong peroxide mixed in my pre-spray. So it's reacting to something organic that's on the carpet. It's eating it up. Same thing right here, and then right there, and right there. That's all where there's something in the carpet that it's reacting with and it's eating up. So we're gonna let that dwell for just a minute. Got something right here I'm gonna hit with a high pH cleaner, a little bit of red or something. I pre-sprayed this one a little heavy. Right back. I get asked, I don't know, it's been a couple weeks in a row now. I've been asked several times about the towel that you clean with. Do you start with it wet or dry? I've always started with it wet. I feel like it works a lot better. Now, a long time ago, what I would do, I would just take it directly out of the water and not wring it out at all and just put it on the carpet. If it's really dirty, you can do that and get away with it. I don't think it's necessary. I think just enough, because when both surfaces are wet, the soil will transfer from the carpet to the towel easier. It'll work either way. Said before, the way this machine cleans is very simple. It's so simple that a lot of people can't get their head around it. They don't understand. They think that in order to clean carpet, you've got to drag a hose in here and use suction to suck the soil out of the carpet. I mean, you don't use a vacuum cleaner to wipe the soil off of your car. So, you know, you don't need a vacuum for this to suck the water out. I'm not cleaning with an inordinate amount of water. I generally get about an hour dry time. Fan up here, it really dries it quickly. The dirtier it is, the more pre-spray you have to use. All right, now I'm gonna clean this, and I don't want people to think you're supposed to clean in a hurry. You know, you're not gonna see a world of difference here whether you clean very slow or just in a hurry to be done. I generally take my time because I feel better about myself when I know I've done a better job. If you just hurry through all this, sure, you can get paid, but you know, you're building bad karma and probably get punished later in life for that. Anyway, I'm gonna start here, go really slow, and just to be thorough. fan on. Let's go take a look at the towel. All right, that is the soil that got removed from this room here. So these guys, they get washed in the washing machine. Sometimes, depending on how soiled the carpet is, you can wash them two or three times to get the majority of the soil out. You'll never get it all out. And the main thing to know is do not add bleach to the water. It is not important to get the towels back perfectly white again. If you use bleach and you clean these towels, they're going to have a very short life. Never, ever use bleach in your mix when you wash these. Same thing to be said of the carpet. No bleach on carpet either. All right, I'm going to groom this guy. We are all done. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching the video. As I said, I am a dealer for Challenger. You purchase the Challenger through me, you get $100 back as a thank you that I mail you out of my own pocket. I get a commission check from selling the Challenger, so I share that with you. You also get to text me anytime you have questions, not after midnight. But you get all of the support that you don't get from any other dealer anywhere. I'm a one-man show, and I'm appealing to other one-man shows, small businesses. So you want to purchase a Challenger, you basically join the Challenger Army. You have me to ask questions to. And every time you ask me a question, it doesn't involve buying something that's going to cost you money. There's generally a short answer to every question that I get answered, that I get asked. And generally, maybe one day a week on Sunday, I don't get text and ask questions. So I do make time for my subscribers. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless. And again, we do have financing now for a Challenger, so if you don't have the money to buy one outright, you can make monthly payments. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless.